loud. Holy shit.
Is it so good?
You have to play it up.
No, I'm not playing it up at all.
It kind of looks like Kugel.
It does look like Kugel. No, there's like 18 different...
Wait, what is
I'm taking another bite.
Again, you already said. It's so good.
Oh my God.
Spiced white chocolate pumpkin spice fudge.
And you made this with your own two hands?
Right.
Yes, and a stove.
Damn.
Oh, that's really good. That's really, really good.
I'm so happy to hear.
Wow, thank you so much.
Wow, Alex, thank you.
Hey, Brooke.
Hi, Connor.
Are you ready to MAP?
I'm ready to pee.
Ignorance is bliss. I'm living in a world of my own, and it's awesome.
Oh, I thought I was responsible for 9/11 when I was 5.
Where were you?
In Pennsylvania. Touch grass, might I suggest.
We're just going to dive right in today.
Connor, what's up, man?
What? What's up? Sorry.
Wake up.
I'm sorry. I was asleep over here.
Why?
I don't know. I laid my DSDF merch over my upper body, and it just lulled me right off to sleep. I was so cozy.
Kind of like a weighted blanket effect.
In a way, but it was a little bit more spiritual than that, I would say.
Very cool.
Yeah.
How about the mug?
Oh, my gosh. That mug.
Yeah.
How about it?
How about it?
What you got in there?
You know. Yeah. I think you know.
I think
what's in my mug piece.
Guys, we have
water. I lied. I don't know why I just lied. Sorry, there's nothing in the mug.
There's nothing in the mug. there's water in it. There's nothing in the mug. But guys, we were alarmed. No, wrong word.
Completely shell shocked.
We were completely knocked out of our socks by the response to the merch. The DSDF merch got like blown off the shelves. Why can't I think of one adjective today or a verb? Blown off the shelves?
Yeah, sounding like hotcakes.
You guys absolutely blew me out of my socks last week with the response to the merch. We sold a ton of our merch, and we've decided to add some more, just so that if anybody couldn't get their hands on it, did we add some more?
Just a limited amount more.
Okay, wait, I'm so sorry, Brooke, will you say it?
I don't know if I can either.
We
have a few pieces left of our merch. If you want to go ahead and grab them, go head on over to tmgstudios.tv and you'll be able to find it from there.
It really is
my favorite merch piece we've ever done. It's so cozy.
I think it looks
cute. And at the end of the day, there's truth to it.
Different strokes,
which is always good
for different folks. Oh, that's a good picture of us.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. I love that photo.
You know, we twinned in that photo shoot by accident.
On accident.
How fun. Ew.
Oh, hello. I hadn't seen it up close.
No, no image ever needs
you know
to
what
that
I, you know what I always say about that photo of my neck and where my neck meets my chin that I couldn't see from over here? Good from far, far from good. So that like when you see someone attractive from far away and you get and you go, I'm gonna act like I need to go over in that direction for some reason. And then you get over and you're like, waste of steps.
Beauty's on the inside.
No, it's what's on the outside that counts. I've always said that.
Mm.
But that's why you should get our merch, because you can wear it on the outside of your body.
Unless
you want to eat it. I'm sure it tastes good.
Okay.
Then it would be on what's on the inside. It's available right now to you at this time. Thank you guys also. Thank you guys so much for buying the merch.
Yes, thank you so much. Can't wait to see maybe some pictures of you in it.
Yeah.
There are so many things that you can do in the merch that I've illustrated already. For example, resting and sleeping. I'd love to see you in your best resting pose in your merch. Yay!
It's a good gift, too. If you already got one,
mm-hmm.
you're like, what do I get my papa or my meemaw?
Yeah.
DSDF merch.
Yeah.
Because that's the thing about DSDF. There's a stroke for everybody.
And it's this sweatshirt.
Yeah, or mug.
Yeah, or mug.
I love a good mug.
Me too.
Because you know what one thing about a mug is? If you have a cool mug, you can like low-key flex behind the mug. That's the thing about liquids is like you get a drink or something at a bar, but you're like, oh, they're at the beach? You know, but like you're just kind of flexing your mug, or like, oh, they're like, they have a really busy Google calendar today. Like, wow, they're busy.
What did you, I'm not understanding anything that you're saying.
If you wake up in the morning and you go to like take a picture of your morning coffee,
yeah,
you know, a lot of times people put like, oh, it's 6:04 a.m. Like they just wanted to post that they're awake.
Oh, like, but it's they're a using good, the mug as a guide.
Yeah.
You do that.
I do that every day.
Yeah.
Anytime I wake up early,
yeah,
people will know.
And on the beach as well.
I'm not going to, yeah, I'm not going to tell anybody, but there will be signs.
Oh my God. That takes the phrase mugshot.
Oh!
To a whole new level.
Brooke, good thinking.
Yeah.
And you said you weren't on your feet today. You said
no,
you weren't on your toes
I'm
today.
Not.
That was good though. But I was saying, like, also, there's this thing, this toxic thing that happens in corporate America where, like, everyone tries to be busier than each other.
Right.
And I had a job where everyone had to, like, it was like you had to share your calendar. Like, you had to make your calendar public, your GCal.
Mm-hmm.
So everyone's calendars were like heads down time, and it was like 3 hours. And I was like, "What are you doing to your heads down time?" They're like, "I just had to fill up that time, so no one like tries to have a meeting with me." They're not doing anything. But I was saying that's a good, easy flex to your coworkers and your peers to be like, "I'm busy today."
Okay.
My calendar's in the back.
Okay. Mugshot.
Mugshot Got vibes. It. Yeah.
Totally. All right, that's a wrap on the merch conversation.
Yeah. Okay. Hey guys, welcome back to Brooke and Connor Make a Podcast. We're something is trying to make its way out of my body via my trachea or whatever,
like,
this part
throw
is.
Throw up? Tell me if you're gonna.
No, it's not throw up. But it
what is,
it? It's a bubble of sorts. But
What did you say when you had the frog in your throat?
Why is it on his
elbow? Oh, I hope we have a repeat. But that's not something you can recreate.
I feel like that'll happen today. I feel like that'll happen today. I was with my parents over Thanksgiving, obviously, and they kept being like, clear your throat when you're talking. I was like, I didn't even know there was something to be cleared out of my throat.
Right. Whew. Well.
Yeah.
How are you?
Good. I'm in the holiday spirit as hell. So I've been jolly. I don't know if it's just like there's stuff happening right now. There's that like end of Q4 rush that it's kind of like everyone's running around, but no one's actually doing
Q4
anything.
Q4 is my least favorite Q.
I love Q4.
Mm. I don't fuck with Q4.
Why? It's the end. It's the end of it.
Because this week of like, or these few weeks from Thanksgiving to Christmas, there is never a point. Just keep Thanksgiving going or start Christmas early.
Oh, facts.
It's just like a waste of space.
My also favorite thing about Thanksgiving is like right before Thanksgiving is like, oh crap, like we need to force in a bunch of stuff before Thanksgiving, before everyone goes on break. And then after it's like, well, we missed a bunch of stuff while everyone was on break during Thanksgiving, so we're forcing a bunch. And then like by next week, it'll be like, we need to get a bunch of stuff in before holidays.
It's just like, it's a shit show every year. And it's like, we'll never learn that this is just a chunk of time we should remove from the calendar.
I agree.
Oh my God, facts.
Yeah, maybe we have the same stroke although we're different folks today.
Yeah, very cool. I love when that happens.
Yeah, I mean, I liked it always in college college, I guess, was finals. But at jobs, it was like, everyone's like, yeah, we're going to be really busy in December. And it's like, no, we're not.
No,
and I'm leaving on the 15th and you won't see me till January.
It's senioritis, but for adults.
I know. But like knowing that, why do we put on airs for each other?
That's the way the world works, unfortunately. It's all an air. Everything's an air.
Brooke, it's all an air.
There's nothing that's not an air.
Sorry.
If we stopped living in air, everyone would be so much happier.
What can we compare that to in the animal kingdom? What? A summer's day. but like, you know, where everyone's like busy, pretending to be busy.
What do you mean compared to in the animal kingdom?
I don't know. I feel like there has to be some comparison in terms of
No, I nature. Think that's the problem.
Oh.
It's not natural.
Yeah.
Ooh. But
I want to know, do other countries do that?
Not as much.
Yeah, because they get like months off. I remember when I went to Bali with my friends and we ran into all these Australians and Canadians and they were like, where are you going after this? And I was like, we're here for 10 days. We have to go home. And they're like, 10 days and then you're going home? I was like, what are you doing? They're like, well, we have a month and a half. So we're going to try to figure out where we should go after this. And I was like, what about your jobs? They're like, we got a month and a half off.
No, it's crazy when you travel to other countries. Like, work is just like a part of people's lives. It's not their life. It's just like something you do to make money so that you can live your life.
Work to live versus live to work.
Which is awesome.
Facts.
It's so nice and they're so much happier.
I like the Spanish countries that have siesta hour. Except I would be so stressed out trying to fall asleep for my nap during siesta hour that it would be the end of my nap and I would fall asleep in like the last.
Connor, that would always happen to my preschoolers. They would stress themselves out so much and that they would work themselves up about them not wanting to go to sleep that they would get so tired they'd fall asleep at the last second of siesta. And then I'd have to wake them up and their parents actually would have to come down and get them because they weren't able to walk up the stairs due to extreme exhaustion.
No, I would genuinely be, this would be me the last like 14 minutes of siesta hour.
Yeah.
Is it over? Like I'm thinking my alarm's going off.
It's like kids don't know how good they have it.
No. Adults don't know how good they have it though.
That I've been thinking about that too. Yeah, I've been thinking about that too.
Great.
But it's kind of like a long spiel that I actually don't even need to get into.
Okay. Well,
do you want me to?
Yeah,
it's
sure.
Actually not. It's just like I've been kind of doing some self-reflection.
Okay, that's good.
I have been so anxious recently, which is why I had to bring my family today.
Yeah.
So Frank, my ESC is here. My emotional support chicken is here as well with Kiki, who's a new addition to the family. This is actually Frank's son.
Can I see Frank?
Yeah, no, this is Kiki.
I'm sorry.
K-I-K-I.
Kiki Palmer.
Yeah.
She's cute. He is cute.
It's Frank's son. Oh, yeah, he's sorry. Darling.
Are all of your plushes men?
They are all young men. As it turns out.
Why do you think that is?
I don't know. I just don't have any daughters. I guess because Frankie's my daughter.
Mm.
That these, maybe they like balance out her feminine energy.
I'm letting you know now that because you brought up the Max is my son conversation, that for the rest of my online life, every picture I put up of Max is going to be flooded with those messages.
Okay, well, mine's always going to be flooded with Frankie having nerve pain, so join the club.
Get Kiki out of my sight.
No.
I'm just kidding.
Do you know this is like there's these crochet kits called Woobles, and so Kiki's a Wooble, and there's so many different options for what you can make. Did you see there's a Dobby one?
Yeah.
There's Dobby featuring sock and Dobby without sock.
What's the price difference in the sock versus no sock?
Oh, good question. Maybe $5 if I had to guess. If I had to spit it out, spitball it.
That's like a lot for a sock. That's like what a normal pair of socks.
How fun are those?
That is fun.
Doesn't Kiki kind of look like a lemon though?
Some chica on Etsy is going ape shit right now, like making these for people and reselling them on Etsy for in time for the holidays.
Kiki like doesn't look like her predecessors. She looks like a lemon.
Oh, like the colors are different. I think the colors.
No, not at all. That's not what I said. It's the shape of her body. Whatever, man. I'm addicted to Kiki.
That'd be a good gift to give.
Oh, Wooble? Yeah.
Yeah. That's kind of like in the same realm as Legos, by the way.
What was I talking about?
Oh, you've been having horrible anxiety.
Horrible anxiety. Like worse than 9/11, truly. Like really bad. But I forget what. My anxiety, not worse than 9/11, the event. Oh my God, no, that's horrible. Cut that. I don't want anyone to think
leave
that.
It on, leave it on.
Oh my God, I didn't mean that at all. Just when I started to get anxiety was at the time of 9/11 because I thought I was responsible for it. If you didn't know that already, I'm not saying my anxiety is worse than 9/11. That would be horrible. But I'm just saying my anxiety now is like similar to how bad it was when I was little. And this is why I got onto that topic.
Hey guys, we want to take a quick break to thank a sponsor of today's episode, ZocDoc. Have you ever been on the hunt for a new doctor and you ask literally everyone you know for their reco? You know, a doctor who actually gets you, listens to you, and makes you feel super comfortable. And finally, after weeks of searching, you find the one. Someone who not only does all that, but they're also close by and you're both Aries, Moon, Rise, Virging. And because that is important. So you call their office and they have an appointment available. Heck yeah. But then the receptionist tells you this perfect doctor doesn't take your insurance. We've all been there. I've been there 8 times, I think, this year. Well, wipe your tears, put away the ice cream, and head over to ZocDoc to find and book the doctor who is right for you and takes your insurance.
ZocDoc is a free app where you can find amazing doctors and book appointments online. We're talking about booking appointments with thousands of top-rated, patient-reviewed doctors and specialists. You can filter specifically for ones who take your insurance, are located near you, and treat almost any condition you're searching for. These docs all have verified reviews from actual real patients, not bots. The average wait time to see a doctor booked on ZocDoc is between just 24 and 48 hours. That's it. You can even score same day appointments.
I've used ZocDoc several times. One for several different things too. One was a general checkup that took 4 appointments to complete. One was a chiropractor, which I didn't think that you could do through ZocDoc, but you can. And I'm going to do a physical therapist as well as try to nip this 2-week cold I've had in the bud. I think today I'll hop on ZocDoc. But go to ZocDoc.com/BNC and download the ZocDoc app for free. Then find and book a top-rated doctor today. That's ZocDoc.com/BNC. ZocDoc.com/BNC.
What were you saying earlier? I don't remember, Connor.
It was like an existential crisis.
Yeah, it was an existential. Anyway, I look back at that time in my life. I forget what made me think of this, but I look back on that time in my life and I'm like, oh my God, like she had nothing to worry about. Oh. It makes me so sad.
Yeah, that's what I was saying.
Yeah, it makes me so sad that like I was so driving myself crazy for no reason. And I wish I could just go back and be like, you have nothing to worry about, Queen.
Yeah.
But now I'm thinking like, oh my God, the 50-year-old version of me is thinking the same damn thing about 27-year-old me needing to sit here with all my family of stuffed animals. But I still can't stop.
That's why I love
is so frustrating.
Self-help books are so good because every time you read one, now they all say the same thing, but each time you read a new self-help book, it's like, oh yeah, I forgot that. And I learned that the last time I read a self-help book. Don't sweat the small stuff.
Yeah.
I keep having dreams in the same realm where not even dreams. I wake up in the middle of the night being like, holy shit, like what if the moon fell onto us? And that's like such a stupid thing. But that is the thing that I wake up thinking. I'm not like, oh, like I really should, you know, like pay my parking tickets. It's like, what if the moon falls on us?
Right. I think it's easier to worry about things that are out of your control than things that are in your control. Or it's just like that's what your mind prefers to do.
I had to apologize to someone the other day because I was like, I'm sorry that you keep having to hound me over the simple tasks, even though I complete the hard tasks
But
the simple tasks, I'm like, you have to give me 1 week.
Yeah.
Texting is my battle right now. How sad is that?
No, you're okay. It's normal. Okay. You're normal.
Thank you, God.
Yeah.
Fuck. I didn't know. I didn't think I was normal when I woke up this morning.
No.
I just told you I'm scared the moon is going to fall on us, and then you said that I'm normal. That makes me feel better.
Oh my God. I'm so glad. Sometimes it's all about just knowing you're not alone.
Yeah.
John Green just made a video that made me cry about that. I love that man.
He's
That's
special.
Not Hank Green, though.
We don't have to get into all the Green family tree. I was listening to holiday music. I was saying I'm in the spirit this year, and not in the spirit the same way that I said I was in Halloween spirit, because that was an error. I was blatantly lying when I said that, and I caught myself and I'm like, ugh, I'm not gonna be able to live up to that.
Mm-hmm.
The Christmas spirit, however, I'm in.
Really?
Yeah, this year.
I can't get into it.
I'm listening to country. The country station here plays Christmas music nonstop. They actually have to apologize to their listener base because they go, hey, we know like a lot of your country fans on the country station, but like we're gonna be playing Christmas music for the next
country Christmas or just Christmas.
It's like Kelly Clarkson.
Okay.
But like a lot of country singers do, like they play the Taylor Swift Christmas tree thing.
What is it? Taylor Swift?
Isn't it called Christmas Trees?
Christmas Tree Farm.
Christmas Tree Farm.
Oh,
there you got a Christmas
that.
Tree farm. Forget how it goes, but that plays a lot. But I was listening to like all these songs. Isn't it weird that like Christmas is like the least relatable thing on the planet, and it's like the biggest thing. Like Let It Snow.
Just in terms of like immaculate conception.
Well, no, I'm talking about mostly the songs. Like most Christmas songs are like the lights are up in the city.
That's
like,
what it's like.
How can
on the East Coast, in the Northeast. It's so Christmassy.
I know, but most people don't live on the East Coast.
But I think, well, I guess it's like where it's cold in general. I think most people live where it gets cold during Christmas.
Cold is one thing.
Yeah, I think when it's cold, it feels really seasonal.
I think lights being up in the city and the jingle bells and stuff of like a horse-drawn carriage, like I couldn't relate to that. And yet I sang along.
Oh, I feel good about that. Yeah. I feel like I can relate.
Well,
to
you're
that.
From Philly,
yeah.
Philadelphia,
yeah,
which is like a major city.
Yeah, but I'm even in the suburbs.
I'm from like where there's cows, so
right.
That was hard to relate to.
Really, when I think of Texas, I think Christmas.
What? Why?
Like cowboys celebrating Christmas together as a family.
The big one big cowboy family.
Yeah, one big happy cowboy family having Christmas supper. No brainer to me.
I can't think of one Christmas song that's about a bunch of cowboys.
Oh my God, you don't know the little cowboy
living
who
together,
celebrated
Brokeback
Christmas?
Mountain style.
Yes, Brokeback Mountain.
Oh, the Christmas classic movie.
Yeah.
Brokeback Mountain.
Yeah, me and my family watch that every Christmas.
That's you know, it's funny. That's actually like a biblically accurate nativity. No, I need to not have that conversation. I was trying to make a joke about it. I can't.
No, you're good.
But that was a thought I had on the way here where it was like, I don't get how we all have agreed that these are the biggest Christmas songs ever.
Which ones?
I looked them up.
All of them?
Well, the ones that
are
play
on
the radio.
Are you upset with all of them?
I'm not upset with all of the Christmas songs. I'm upset that like...
The specific ones about the lights?
They're all about New York.
What is upsetting you specifically?
I wasn't upset. I'm not upset.
What can you? So you can't relate to the lights?
I'm saying it's shocking that we all agree. It's hard to get my words out. I'm not making sense. But
no,
I,
sweetheart, it's okay.
I
you
pray,
are. I get it. I get it. You can't relate to the
lights.
You
I'm
can't
saying.
Relate to the lights. I'm sorry. It must be hard.
Brooke, every day I come onto this podcast and I have to find something to complain about.
Mm-hmm.
I'm fine with the songs. I'm in the spirit. I'm jolly. I'm going to get a tree. I'm sweating so bad.
Oh my God.
What's your favorite song?
Good question, Ryan. Thanks for asking the hard-hitting question.
My favorite song is that one with the weird voice that pops in.
Hippopotamus?
I am dreaming of a white Christmas. But it's by The Drifters.
Are there a few different versions
There's
of that
100
one? I think
versions.
I don't know that specific one.
There's 100 versions. You know what would be a real challenge?
Mm.
Write a new Christmas song. Dare you.
I actually think that would be the easiest kind of song to write. Oh my God. Did you know I saw this clip on TikTok of The Basement Yard? That's what they're called, mm-hmm. right? I love them so much.
Me too.
Talking about I Saw Mommy Kissing Santa Claus.
Mm-hmm.
Had no idea this whole time that Santa Claus is their dad. I thought she was cheating as well as they did.
Is it not open to interpretation?
I don't think so.
I feel like it is also like an adult song.
No, I think it's like I saw mommy kissing Santa Claus, but I don't know that it's my dad because I'm a kid and I don't know that Santa's not real.
Right. I saw mama kissing Santa
like,
Claus.
And she's like,
underneath.
The kid's like, oh my God, mom is cheating on dad. It is dad. That's something we have access to that the narrator doesn't.
Just
because she believes in Santa.
That's classic. Like, oh my gosh, coming of age situation. Now I understand what mama kissing Santa Claus is about.
Yeah.
It's kind of like panty raid vibes.
Like what?
Panty raid vibes.
Oh, in what way?
Like Santa has broken into their home via chimney feature and is now making out with their mom.
Santa's panty raiding?
Santa raid?
The Santa raid.
Not the Santa raid. He came in through the chimney, breaking and entering much. It's how many more years do we have with Santa being dead?
Like before Santa's canceled?
Before Santa's out. Like, I'm being serious.
No, I totally think we're headed in that direction.
Everything about him is just like, oh, typical white man.
Mm-hmm.
Like, oh, he's employing a bunch of like textbook. If we're saying that like being below what like 4'10" is technically
right.
a disability,
right?
So he's all of his employees are disabled. Do you think he's providing them with appropriate insurance for year round? Even though that
performance reviews,
performance.
I don't think I don't know in the North Pole. Like they probably have their society is probably just more accessible for. Maybe I should move to the North Pole.
Maybe you should.
It's probably built for
no, Brooke,
people.
You would be so cold
of my stature.
But you could rest almost year round. Or are you building toys year round?
No, you're building toys year round.
Hmm.
You are on the clock every day. Christmas is every day.
Okay. No, Christmas is what they're working towards their whole
exactly,
year.
Exactly, but I'm just saying Christmas is the focal point of every day.
I'm trying, what could I compare thee to? It's like everyone that works at like Golden Voice, they produce Coachella every year. It's like they work on Coachella year round, but Coachella only happens that one weekend. But then as soon as Coachella is over, they start getting music.
Yeah, so
music.
They're going elf mode.
Yeah.
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 Hey guys, we want to take a quick break to thank a sponsor of today's episode, StoryWorth. This holiday season, I want to give a gift to my loved ones that makes them feel special and unique, just like the relationship we share. That's why I'm giving everyone I care about StoryWorth. StoryWorth is an online service that helps you and your loved ones preserve precious memories and stories for years to come. It's a thoughtful and meaningful gift that connects you to those who matter most.
Every week, StoryWorth emails your relative or friend a thought-provoking question of your choice from their vast pool of possible options. Each unique prompt asks questions you've never thought to ask, like, what's the bravest thing you've ever done in your life? Or, if you could see into the future, what would you want to find out? What would you want to find out if you could see in the future, Brooke?
I don't want to see in the future.
What would you think that the bravest thing you've ever done in your life is?
The bravest thing I've ever done?
Yeah.
Probably get up this morning and come here.
It's all relative.
It's all relative.
Then after 1 year, StoryWorth will compile all your loved ones' stories, including photos, into a beautiful keepsake book that you'll be able to share and revisit for generations to come. I got this for my dad last year. I can't wait to see what his responses are. He's kind of like a little bit behind, so I did have to follow up several times. He just is not good at his email, which was passed down to me. That's the sixth trait that is passed down from your father, is we don't open our emails. What was the one he asked? I think I asked him about like a childhood story where he thought he was gonna get in trouble from his mom, or they asked him. And he talked about getting hit by a truck, which I'd never heard. And he was upset because he got his shirt dirty and it was his church shirt. And I was like, that is like the funniest thing that I never.
And he was scared his mom was gonna get
mad. Yeah, so he like went and took it home and was like cleaning it. And I was like, were you injured from getting hit by the truck? You got run over.
That's sad.
We've both been hit by cars too. Maybe that's the seventh trait passed down from your father.
Reading the weekly stories helps you connect with loved ones no matter how near or far apart you are. With StoryWorth, I'm giving those I love the most thoughtful, personal gift from the heart and preserving their memories and stories for years to come. Go to StoryWorth.com/BNC and save $10 on your first purchase. That's StoryWorth.com/BNC to save $10 off your first purchase.
But you've got an elf with a hammer putting together toy after toy after toy. I'm sure talk about AI taking people's jobs. Imagine when they start automating toys in the North Pole, automating machines. What do they do for work at that point? Now, then you start getting...
I can't tell if you right now are thinking that elves are real.
In my mind right now, when we're chatting about this, because okay. I'm about to move on to reindeer.
The discussion is a moot point.
Do you want to move on to reindeer?
If you need to.
Okay. So now we've got an employee of Santa who's Rudolph, who everyone's calling, hey, stinky Rudolph. Hey, loser, like dumbass Rudolph with your nose. You're different than us and you suck because of that.
Right.
And then like something happens and Santa now needs him to step up and now everybody likes him. They're gaslighting him into thinking he's the man.
Mm-hmm.
That's an interesting point as well.
Yeah.
That's not an HR compliant situation. And then we just go to Santa at his bare bones. He's breaking and entering every single time and providing gifts for children so that they like him. Groomer? Is he grooming
Oh
him?
My God. Okay.
We're crossing over now.
We're going there. We're doing grooming.
Anyways, guys, enjoy Santa while we have him, because I'm sure he'll be replaced by AI in the coming months.
Ho.
Ho, ho, ho. Watch this space. Also, that's his phrase. Ho, ho, ho.
Yeah. I see what you're saying.
Yeah.
But I'm just not like there in terms of the passion. But maybe one day.
Okay, if you can't put into passion, you can't put passion into your work, what do we have?
No, I agree. It's just, is that my work to do? Maybe it's just yours.
Maybe it's my maybe.
Yeah,
it's my
maybe
fight
that's
to
your
fight.
Journey.
I'm not fighting for or against Santa. I've moved on personally.
It doesn't seem like you have.
I'm a Santa truther.
Okay.
Take it as you will.
Okay. Totally.
Where do we go from here?
Speaking of toys, I just wish that it was socially acceptable for adults to hold and carry stuffed animals with them throughout the day as it is with children. Like, I want to be able to walk into a store holding...
I feel like you have yours all the time, Brooke.
No, only when I'm like doing the pod or resting at home. Like I want to be able to walk into the mall with carrying three stuffed animals. Do you know how hard it is for me to walk past that Squishmallow store and not buy out the place? I want every single one.
You can.
No, I know I can, but I'm not the one. I don't want to take the lead on the bringing back stuffed animals into adult culture.
See, Brooke,
movement.
That's,
I want someone else to take the lead.
You're lacking the passion that I have for Santa, for your stuffed animals.
No, I have the passion, but it's like I'm very much. I'm not a follower. I'm not a leader. I'm a co-host. So it's like I need someone else to do it first, and then I will be leading the charge with them. I will be heading the movement as long as someone else does it first.
You're beheading the movement.
Yeah.
I think...
Like, I want 15,000 Squishmallows in my apartment. I want to not be able to walk into my apartment because I want it to just be Squishmallows.
You could
and other various stuffed animals, including, but not limited to, Build-A-Bear, Woobles, etc.
You could order them online.
Woobles?
No, Squishmallows if you want them.
I know. But, like, that store...
Brooke, I implore you to go into the Squishmallow store.
You won't. You would never speak to me again if I was walking around with Squishmallows.
No, you have to put them in your car, and then I'll meet
exactly,
you outside. But
exactly.
Like
imagine like we
get...
have like a nice event. Like I want it to be fine for me to walk in with an emotional security stuffed animal.
To a nice event?
Yes.
Oh well, that's not.
I'm saying I want that to be. Because if a baby did that...
Right, well, if a baby did a lot of things...
It would be fine. But I'm not hurting anyone.
No. I cannot fight this fight with you.
Wow, we are fighting completely different fights today.
DSDF.
Totally.
I think saying, well, if a baby did that, is a... I want to help you out moving
right,
forward.
Right, dangerous road to start going down.
Start out the argument with, well, a baby can do it, so I feel like I should be allowed. I'm trying to think of anything that a baby does that I don't do. You can't
poop in your diaper.
I don't have a diaper on, but I have.
But like, you could, and we could normalize it.
I don't. That's like something that I'm cool not normalizing is pooping in my diaper. For me.
Really?
Screaming on a plane. Cool not normalizing that for adults.
But I do feel like. Sure.
Crawling
yeah.
on all fours at a Target. Sure. Cool not normalizing that for adults.
Sure. But I'm just saying, okay, at what age would you see someone walking into an establishment carrying a stuffed animal and be like, you're too old to be doing that? 30?
Yeah, I would say probably 30 would okay. be a good cutoff.
Okay.
You have time. Enjoy it.
Yeah.
You should take it to the Wonka premiere on Sunday.
Oh my God, should I walk into Wonka with not only Frank, but Kiki as well.
Yeah, you should.
Okay.
I'm sure you'll get to cut the line. Okay.
Oh, heavens to Betsy. Seriously.
So circling back, I went, I moved into my apartment yesterday and I didn't actually move in. Cause I
didn't think you moved in yesterday.
I got it. Yesterday was my first day where
keys?
I like, had my keys for my apartment. And I went to pick them up. And I told you guys, because I was going to meet Brooke and Kat for a meal, for a delicious Tuesday evening
meal. The
good
news is we didn't end up eating, because we shopped till we dropped.
I understand. I can't shop at all until I drop. I try on one pair of pants, and I'm a broken man.
I got 14,000 steps.
That's bonkers. How many stores did you go to?
All of them.
I go into one store. If I go into Gap and I try on a pair of pants, I'm itching. I itch. My skin itches. I'm like... I'm freaking out.
Mm-hmm. No, I wasn't happy at all.
That's why Zara.
I had Kiki in my purse, thankfully.
Oh, thank God you were able to get
yeah,
this.
Yeah, so I was
him
kind of
squeeze.
I was giving him a squeeze.
If I go into a Zara, I'm a ticking time bomb for an anxiety attack.
I do think it's store dependent as well. Zara is much more anxiety producing than say Anthropology.
Anthropology, if they had like. An area to get a 10-minute massage. Mm-hmm. I would go there just to do that.
Yeah, Anthropology is pretty relaxing, especially because it has that plant store attached to it.
What do you girls have that doesn't have a guy's section that's so pleasant? Aritzia. Aritzia doesn't have a guy's section, but I love sitting in that store. Their
yeah,
couches
they
are
have
so
great couches. I had a weird experience in Aritzia yesterday.
Oh,
it's not
care
really
to share?
A story worth telling, though.
Okay.
I guess it was some guy was like, oh my God, hi, he works there. Yeah. And I was like, hi. And he was like, it's been a few months. And I was just like, yeah, on God, never seen him in my life. And then another employee came up, was like, oh, you two know each other? And then he was like, yeah. And I was like, yeah, yeah. And then she was like, you're not working today? It was already 5:30. And I was like, what is happening?
What was happening?
I don't know. He knows me. She's upset I'm not at work at 5:30. I guess she also doesn't know I wouldn't be working at 3:30 or 1:30 as well, in addition, but she didn't know that. Yeah, it was interesting. That's it. Uneventful, no, and yet eventful at the same time.
That's just like that thing here that happens, I feel like, in LA, where you're just like, I think I know that person.
But do you think...
But I'll never act on that.
Right, I wonder if he just like maybe has seen my face before and was like, I actually did see her 2 months ago in the store, kind of conflating the two.
But he didn't care to step in when his peer asked if you were working today?
I don't think that...
We're not working in the store.
Oh my God, you think she meant working in the... Do you think they thought I worked there?
I think so. That's what I felt.
Oh, I thought she just meant like, why am I not like sitting on my computer? Oh, they thought I was an employee.
Yeah, that's what I thought. That's what I heard.
Oh, yeah. Connor, that makes much more...
Like, why haven't you clocked in? Because you need to...
But I was shopping.
We need help in the bathroom.
I guess employees can shop there too.
That's a funny thing about Anthropology. Or no, you Aritzia? Were at Aritzia, but my friend worked at Anthropology, which is a subsect of Free People, right, as well as Urban Outfitters. Yes. And so
Father,
she was able,
Son, Holy Spirit,
she was able to shop there. And then at the end of her summer job there, she owed them $600 because she spent so much money at the conglomerate.
Yeah. That's an awesome conglomerate.
Yeah.
I've always loved those, that family of three.
You know what I love? When someone says sister company, that's our sister company.
I like that
too. I don't know why. That's going to be our sister company over there.
Yeah.
You never hear about a brother company. Mm-mm. They're always trouble. Sister company. That's our sister company over there.
I like that too, Connor.
You do?
Yeah.
Why do you think we like that so much?
I think it's because we're used to hearing like male dominated yeah. phrases. And so sister is kind of refreshing.
Yeah. That's our mama company.
Yeah. Yeah, that's our mother company.
Mother
is that what
company?
You would say?
Oh my God, yeah.
Yeah.
Cool. That's our grandma yeah. company.
Yeah.
That's our Mimi, my mom. Mm-hmm. Okay, what was I saying? I am moving into, I got my keys to my new apartment. And so I was just going to pick up my keys, right?
How many minutes away is your new apartment from your old apartment?
4.
Walking or driving?
Driving.
But it's further away from me?
Yeah.
Okay.
So it's only 4 minutes driving, because you actually have to like take a lot of turns.
Right. There.
But so I'm thinking I'm like going to meet her outside, and I like, where is she? And I'm waiting for 5 minutes, and finally I'm like, I'm just going to check if the door to my apartment is open. And I open the door. She's in my apartment barefoot with a pile of grapes.
It is so interesting how some people are like, it's more respectful to be barefoot, and some people are like, it's more respectful to have shoes on, and we'll just like never know the truth.
Guys, this show is sponsored by BetterHelp. Listen, what's your family's policy on gift giving during the holidays?
Horrible gift givers.
Horrible gift givers?
Yeah.
My family has never given gifts, and they like justify it in different ways.
Except for my mom.
Well, that's special that you have a mom.
Yeah.
Mimi, my mom, sends me like whatever cash she finds in her purse.
Uh-huh. That's sweet.
Every
though.
Year
She's
for my
thinking
birthday.
Of you.
It's always fun to guess the amount because it's always kind of random. But we usually go on a trip. My family will go on a trip, and then it will be like,
that's good.
Yeah, like, so that's always fun. Whether or not your family gives gifts during the holidays, you get to define how you give to yourself. So whether it's starting therapy, going easier on yourself during the tough moments, or treating yourself to a day of complete rest, remember to give yourself some love this holiday season.
Therapy has been an incredibly positive experience for me.
Mm-hmm.
It offers a safe space that has helped me gain self-awareness, understand the root causes of my challenges, etc. With therapy, I've learned positive coping mechanisms that have allowed me to become the best version of myself. Oh, mm-hmm. God.
If you're thinking of starting therapy, give BetterHelp a try. It's entirely online, designed to be convenient, flexible, and suited to your schedule. Just fill out a brief questionnaire to get matched with a licensed therapist, and switch therapists at any time for no additional charge.
In the season of giving, give yourself what you need with BetterHelp. Visit betterhelp.com/BNC today to get 10% off your first month. That's BetterHelp, HELP.com/BNC.
I get being barefoot in like a furnished apartment, but this is like an unfurnished apartment. So I get in there. She's actually like flamingoing her feet, where like one is like up like this, and she's barefoot.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, okay, she's doing yoga. And
I love that position.
It's
That's
very
how I
comfortable.
Sleep.
I'm talking about a woman that like doesn't live in my apartment, and she's in there flamingoing, eating some grapes.
Okay.
And then she's like, hello, like all this stuff.
Hi all.
Literally, hi all. And she's got the door, the other door to my apartment open. So she like came in through the side, which I'm, so anyways, all this. And then my back window's open and like there's a breeze flowing through the space. And I'm like, okay, I'll take the keys and then you can kind of head out now. Which
she wasn't ready to
great.
Leave yet.
So she was kind of explaining. She wrote down on a paper towel in Sharpie a bunch of nuances that she was unable to read back to me because she couldn't read her handwriting. And she was like, what do you think this means? And I was like, it says pile. She's like, oh my gosh, yes, the pile next to the back door. And I was like, the pile next to the back door. And then one said shower rock. And I was like, does this say shower rock? And she goes, oh yes. Let me take you into the bathroom. She takes me. This is a lease I've already signed. I want to be frank. I want to be clear. So I walk into the bathroom with her, and she takes me into the shower, which is one thing. She's barefoot. And I'm like, now I'm in this small room with you. You're like shoeless Joe. And then she goes, okay, so here's this window. And she opens it, and she's like, you're going to want to use this rock to prop the window open, full-blown boulder. In the shower, you're gonna want to open the window and then put the rock in the window every time you shower. And I was like, I can't believe how much I'm paying for this apartment. And then she's walking me through all these other things where she goes, if you plug something into this outlet, let me take you over here. And she walks me across the apartment. You need to unplug whatever's in this outlet.
Oh.
And I was like, this would have been good info,
right,
before I moved in.
Right. It's, you know what, Connor, it's never gonna be that way. You're always going to find out this information after you sign your
lease.
That's the lease of life.
That is the lease.
That's just the way.
The lease of life, Brooke.
That's the way life works.
The lease. It is.
You're going to find out that your outlet's connected to a different house after you've already signed the lease.
Yeah.
On God.
And then I told you last time that I'm responsible for the plants. Did I tell you that?
Vaguely.
So I have a back patio that she's unable to access except through my apartment. And so the agreement was, I have to keep the plants that are already on the back patio alive because they're hers.
No.
And
kill one. What happens?
I pay for it out of pocket. I didn't have time.
Can't she just remove them?
I don't think she has space because when you come over and see it, there's so many plants. But the agreement on the lease, and this is something that we're like, my like attorney like looked at it and was like, I really think that you should amend this. And I was like, I don't have time because what she's going to do is find someone who's like
addicted,
really, really wants this place, and that's going
to
be the deal breaker. So like, whatever, I'll water the plants 3 times a week, which is a crazy amount of times a week. So she
what
tells me-
What kind of plants are they?
Roses. And I freaking hate roses.
Oh.
I hate roses. Like probably my least favorite plant because they grow like a bush, and then all you get after an entire- You're talking about
what is the point of her having a rose bush if she's never gonna see it or
you're talking use it? About 90% shrub, 98% shrub with thorns, 1, maybe 2% reward flower.
Okay, but she's not even reaping the 2%.
She's able
not
to,
there.
She's able to walk.
What's the point of having a plant?
I don't know, Brooke.
That you don't have.
But she was able to share with me that the water source connected to my apartment has a hose that I just need to leave on for 3 to 4 hours 3 times a week.
You have to move.
I think I'm going to kill them. I think I'm going to kill the plants. And then by the time she figures out, I'll be like, I'll just pay you for the new flower. You're not sitting out on my patio.
How much do you think all of her plants totaled are? Like how much would you owe should you kill them?
I don't really get how much plants cost. I know they're more expensive than one would think.
You know, I finally killed one of my plants.
Oof, sorry. That big one with the big leaves?
No, the other one, big one.
Oh, I know what you're talking about. Yeah. Damn, sorry.
It's all right. She lived a good life.
I killed one that is impossible to kill, everyone says.
a succulent. Succulents are so easy to kill. I don't know why everyone says
no,
so
I killed
easy
my succulent really easily.
I killed
too.
Those in 6 seconds.
It's like, oh, you're overwatering me. Oh, you're underwatering me.
Oh, there's too much done.
Like, you need to choose a battle. Mm-hmm. Because I didn't even have any water today.
Right. Yeah.
Also, I figured out that like LA water, you cannot give to plants. It kills them. And I'm like, I am drinking tap water 24/7. What's it doing to me?
Oh, my plants have been living off LA water. They're completely fine except for the dead one.
Well, the ones that I killed have been just drinking tap water. And then when I started giving them my Brita water, totally fine.
Weird.
It's because of the heavy metal.
But okay. Okay. I have not used my Brita in 3 years.
Just
due to not wanting to refill it.
I know. It sucks. It sucks so bad. They should make like a huge Brita that you turn on the hose for 3 to 4 hours twice a week. And then it fills up and then you drink out of it like a thirsty hamster.
I'll know that I've made it when I have a house that has filtered water on the fridge door.
Yeah.
And then I'll know that I'm like loaded rich when there's that filtered option on the sink. Where like the instant
I'm moving out of a living situation that has all of those things and into a place that I have to put a rock in my window every time I shower. I like places with character. Sue me. I do. Not too much character where like I have to like remember to unplug something across the apartment when I plug something in on this side. But like I like that it has open shelves.
Everything's a trade-off.
And I like that it has outdoor space.
Yeah. No roommates.
Facts. No roommates. Oh my gosh, I want to tell you guys a funny story in bonus, so I will do that. You just reminded me.
How was your weekend?
It was really good. I went up to San Francisco. I love San Francisco yet again. Got to see a bunch of
I've never been.
I know. It's a really cool place. I think it's too cold. I don't think you would like it right now. It's too cold.
How cold is it?
Freezing.
How freezing is it?
Probably 55.
I'll be okay.
Yeah. But it was good. Nothing to report, really. On that end.
Oh.
Nothing except, I posted on my Instagram story. Obviously, like, I was with, like, 15, 20 people that, and, like, it was like a reunion thing for, like, a lot of my friends. So, we were, like, drinking. We, like, had a big lunch and everything and, like, had drinks and whatever. Yeah. And so, like, by midnight, which was 6 p.m., when you're day drinking, I was, like, making poor judgment decisions in terms of I posted on my Instagram story a video of me and Hank who we were having a really valid conversation. This is not something I would normally post on my Instagram story, and that's why it was.
Oh, I noticed. I saw that. Is that the one where you were just slurring a little bit?
Yeah.
Okay.
We weren't like slurring.
I just know when you're drunk.
Yeah.
I just noticed it.
But we were having an actual conversation where like everyone knows I don't like smoke weed a ton, but like.
You always say that, and then every single episode you're like, oh, I was high.
At some point, sure. I'm not like smoking weed every day. I don't own a weed pen or any like physical weed. I just have the cans.
I just feel like you're more of a weed god than you think you are. Don't sell yourself short.
Like anytime I am doing any weed, it's like the smallest amount, and then I have I'll take like one hit of weed or like I'll have like a small can. But anyways, I was talking to Hank and I was like, anytime I do weed and I eat something spicy, it enhances the spice so much to where I think it's a medical emergency. And he's like, that is not a thing. And I was like,
is this what you were filming?
So like, yeah. So I had posted it and I was like, sound off in the comments. Like, do you guys think food tastes spicier? And 70% of people were like, yes, it gets way spicier.
Right.
And 30% of people were like, no, that's not a thing. But I posted that. And so Sunday morning, I woke up to a text from my mom that said, are you trying to change your image? Asking for a friend. And I was like, what? And she's like, just talking about weed online. I was just like, this is like Sunday scaries to the absolute max that like I posted what I thought was like a harmless Instagram story. Right. And my mom's like probably in a group text with like seven of her tennis friends, like having a genuine conversation about me changing my image.
You talk about drinking all the time, though. So why would weed be like...
I don't know. Weed seems...
I guess for...
Weed is legal.
I know.
Like, I'm confused.
I guess that there's still that like...
Taboo.
Taboo of weed, which like, we should take part in the movement of ending that. By speaking about it more.
Speaking
as you've been
out.
Doing.
By speaking out. Speaking out. But like, obviously, every time I talk about weed, it's like, I was so high. I like had to leave a restaurant because I put red pepper on my pizza right. and it like overwhelmed my taste buds.
Right.
But I had to respond and be like, no, I'm not trying to change my image. Was just chatting with a friend. Mm-hmm. And she said, or I was like, I don't know.
Did you keep the story up or did you get anxiety to delete it?
Nope. I left it up because I said, you know what? If people are triggered by me talking about things being too spicy when I smoke weed, like they can't be here anyways. They need to go.
Yeah. Good.
So,
that's a good app.
Sayonara. But that was Sunday scaries to the absolute maximum is to get a text from your mom saying, oh, I see you're kind of rebranding as a delinquent today.
Yeah. I can understand that that's scary vibes.
That was scary. And then I got on a plane and came back.
My parents like never say anything. And sometimes I'm like, that's awesome that they don't say anything. And then I'm like, do you care that I'm smoking weed? Maybe you should. On God.
I don't know. Like, I don't know why mine would care though.
It's like, right.
You know, I'm an adult.
I don't know. Grass is always greener.
But then I was thinking like, okay, if my mama thought that, like how many other mamas are out there following me that are like,
I think like no one would be like completely shocked to their system that you smoke weed a few times.
Yeah, you're right.
You know, like if there's a mama following you who like truly is like, oh my God, like this changes everything. It's time to go.
It's time to go.
You know?
Yeah. How was your weekend though? Mine was really nothing to report back. It was just like,
right. Kind of bad.
Oh no.
Just like in terms of anxiety, but the anxiety really kicked off Friday night.
Okay.
We had an event, and by we, I mean me and Ryan. Ryan was there, called Chainfest, which like I'm still like not exactly 1000% positive of what it is, but it's like all these chain restaurants.
Oh.
In the same space.
Yeah, it's a food thing.
Yeah, and you get a passport and you just like go visit all the different stations and get your passport stamped. And I think BJ Novak either like organizes it or is an investor or something.
Too.
So all of like his celebrity friends come. And on the email they sent out, it was like, John Mayer will be there, like Mindy Kaling, like all of these like huge names. And whenever you see that, it's just like, okay, they're not going to be there. Connor, everyone was there. So before I get there, I have convinced myself that Andrew Garfield is going to be there. Okay, because he's been around LA and I have always said, do not put me in a room with him. Okay, please God, never. Like I'm not even saying that to be like quirky. I'm like, please, like, please, please, please
don't put me in a room under any circumstances with a man.
Please, ever. So I'm like on edge thinking about if he's going to be there because I've gotten a few DMs that like, they're like, oh, I just saw him like at the Grove.
Yeah.
Like, feeling unsafe. As I'm ruminating on that, I body to body shoulder check Nathan Fielder. Hey guys, we want to take a break to thank a sponsor of today's episode, Squarespace. Squarespace is the all-in-one website platform for entrepreneurs to stand out and succeed online. Whether you're just starting out or managing a growing brand, Squarespace makes it easy to create a beautiful website, engage with your audience, and sell anything from products to content to time, all in one place, all on your terms.
Squarespace allows you to sell your products on an online store. So whether you sell physical, digital, or service products, Squarespace has the tools you need to start selling online. They also have professional website templates with designs for every category and use case. Then you can customize your look, update content, and add features to fit your unique needs. You can make any Squarespace template do what you want so your idea, brand, or business stands out online on every device.
Squarespace helps you grow your business with insights. Learn where your site visits and sales are coming from and analyze which channels are most effective. Improve your website and build a marketing strategy based on your top keywords or most popular products and content.
Mm.
Squarespace also has powerful blogging tools to share stories, photos, videos, and updates. Categorize, share, and schedule your posts to make your content work for you.
Head on down to squarespace.com for a free trial. And when you're ready to launch, go to www.squarespace.com/BNC to save 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain. That's squarespace.com/BNC to save 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain.
And now at this point, I text Ryan. I say, are you here? I'm in Cocktail City. Because that was the location name of the cocktail place, Cocktail City. I do this every time.
Like, I thought you meant just like a mindset, like I'm in Cocktail City.
No, I was
City
in,
right
I
now.
Was located in Cocktail City. Every time I am in a room with a celebrity crush, it's my behavior is unacceptable. It's not okay. I get so panicked. It's like, I don't, like, there's an option available to me that just like, you don't have to go say hi. Just like, enjoy being in the same space. It's okay. Like, you don't have to feel the pressure to say anything. I get so in my head of like, I have to make like the most incredible impression that I start downing cocktails every single time.
Right.
So in Cocktail City, downing cocktails.
Cocktail City population, Cocktail City, Lady Efron.
Population Lady Efron. I just like became a menace. Just kind of like not saying anything to him at all, but putting myself near him and being like, I'm sure he could feel my energy.
Yeah.
Like in a horrible way. In a horrible way. Kind of just like, anyway, that was really it.
You got a photo with him.
Yeah, but like he was just like in the background, and then I was very embarrassed about that the next day.
No.
Yeah. But anyway, just if I could communicate with God for just a second. Do not put me in a room with my celebrity crushes anymore, please. Unless, here are the following ways in which it would be acceptable. I guess like if I'm going to see them and they're on a stage right. And there's no pressure of any sort to say anything, that's fine. That's good. I encourage it. God, please put me in that room. Maybe like in a Black Mirror type of world where we're on stage, if they want to come to that, don't tell me. I don't want them to tell me that they're coming.
Yeah.
But let me do really well on the stage and then see that they're there after. Mm-hmm. That would work too. Mm-hmm. God. And then I guess like if you like really feel like I can pull it together and that I'm able to make an impression that will last a lifetime. Yeah. Put them in the room with me. Only if you're actually able to enter my body and take over and interact in
God,
a way that a normal that a normal person should react. Other than those three instances, don't put me in a room with a celebrity crush, please. It's not good for anyone.
Brooke,
it's not good for me. It's not good for the crush. It's not good for Ryan.
It's good to lay it out like that because specifics are so important in this case, in this use case.
Anyway, you know who else was there?
Who?
I went with Megan.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Megan She's is my good, dear, dear friend. She is the only person I've ever met in my life that rivals my celebrity obsession, crush, personality, behavior. The first thing she said to me when I met her, or one of the first things, was that she wants to live in the space between John Mayer's teeth. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
That's the first thing she's ever said to me. John Mayer's at the event.
Yes.
Megan is so competent. She walked right up to him. They have the most incredible discussion about his music.
She talked to him?
Ryan, he was rubbing her arm.
Was this after I left?
This was after you left. I have photos. Photos of the conversation. They literally like looked like they had been friends since birth.
Wow.
If I could have a little bit of that grace.
How long after I left?
I will say around the night became a little bit hazy to me. But not probably not long. I don't think we were there that long after you left because I got upset. So, yeah. They were like really old friends.
That's awesome.
Who else was there? Who else was there?
Andy Cohen.
Andy Cohen.
Oh, Andy Cohen.
With John.
Chris Pratt.
Mindy Kaling, who I didn't see for the best.
Rachel Bilson.
Wow, that's so cool.
Chrissy and John.
Yeah, John Legend, Chrissy Teigen.
Just like a lot of just like surprising people that you wouldn't expect to be at a fast food event.
As an ethical clout chaser.
Oh, you would have been.
As well as a narcissist. It would have been really hard for me to be there. And that would have been too much for me to be like, I am on the clock ethically clout chasing right now. I need to whisper in everybody's ear some quiet nothings.
Sweet nothings?
Sweet nothings. That's the word I was looking for.
Yeah. So just if I could never be in a room with any of my celebrity crushes again, except for the outlined circumstances or possible outcomes, I would really appreciate it. Because I think that's honestly what set me off.
Well, each step forward is a step forward.
I took about 18 steps back.
Well, now it's just time to revisit those steps as you move back forward out of the backwards part.
Also, just talking about Nathan for 1 second, he seems completely normal, just from where I was standing. Like, talking to people in a way that was just like...
How close were you to him while he talked to
inches.
People? Inches. Oh, okay. I was going to say, I don't think he's very...
He seemed completely socially competent.
Wow.
Which, we'll never know who he is.
No.
He could be doing a bit of social competence, and we'll never know.
Mm-hmm. Hmm. I don't know.
But then I woke up the next morning, and you know when your anxiety is so bad, you're Googling, like, how to stop anxiety, even though you know the answers, and you've also Googled that 15,000 times, hoping that there will be, like, a magic article.
Like, oh, maybe they did more research over the weekend.
Oh, yeah. Maybe you can go to CVS and get this magic pill
yeah.
that they just invented, actually, today.
Yeah.
That's Benadryl. When you know it's bad is the Googling.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's always bad.
Googling things you know the answer to.
The one big thing I have, especially if you're, like, in bed, because I told you guys I keep waking up thinking the moon is falling on me.
Right.
And I'm like, what could I do to stop that? Nothing. Please tell me they have created a device to stop the moon or blow it up or something if it starts falling on us. Like,
Hank Green said that nothing will come out of the sky in our lifetime.
I know.
We don't want to come
Brooke,
out of the sky.
Brooke, I have to keep revisiting that tweet via from Hank Green.
Yeah.
That you put me on to.
Yeah.
Thank God you put me on to that. Because, like, every single day, like, Insta-single or puberty or one of those huge meme things has, like, a news article that, like, looks so official. And it's like, there's an asteroid that's heading right towards Earth. And then I have to be like, Hank Green said it's not going to hit us. So
right. I think you... need to, like, vary your news sources.
I think I need to stop talking about space right now.
Okay.
Okay. You know what came out yesterday? Should we do some quick rapid fire pop C?
Yeah. Ooh, wait, can I say one more thing?
Hit me.
I have, since we saw Saltburn a few weeks ago and discussed it on last week's pod, I'm experiencing something that is what I guess I call a delayed hyperfixation.
Right. I know where you're going to go with this.
Where it's like, you know those medications you take that are, like, extended release, where it's like you have your first dose and then it starts gradually, like, working over time?
Yeah.
That's what's happening to me with Saltburn. Watching the movie was my first dose.
Mm-hmm.
And gradually over time, I'm becoming more and more obsessed with it, hyperfixating in different ways. I'm in love with Barry Keoghan.
Right.
I had no idea that was coming.
I could have called that.
Really?
When I texted you last week and said,
I'm completely shocked.
Did you notice that in the camera angles when they were intentionally trying to make him seem like God in that movie?
I had no idea this was coming.
It was very intentional.
Also,
I think that's almost like Prisoner's Complex. What's that called?
Stockholm Syndrome?
Stockholm Syndrome. I
there's
name
something
that something
about
different
him.
Every
there's
time
there's something
I say
about
it.
Him that's intoxicating.
You're not alone. Go check his Instagram comments.
No, I know. I'm one of them.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Someone said, he winks and my clothes fall off. I'm like, I don't think we're looking at the same hombre. But
it's really, it's a unique experience I'm having. To go from seeing it, being obsessed with Jacob Elordi, and then sitting with it over time, and now having a completely different
experience. I think you can.
Experience. I'm going to see it again.
I think
I
you
need
can,
to.
You can thank the cinematography for that. I'm serious. Now, go watch that movie in the sense of, like, when he's in the same room, I don't know how much we can say. Spoiler alert for, like, the next 15 seconds, okay? 3, 2, 1. When he's in the same room with Jacob and he's, like, the bad guy, they pin him as, like, he dresses like shit. He's so tiny. He's, like, evil,
what
whatever.
What do you mean bad guy? He's the bad guy the whole time.
I know, but, like, when they want to frame him as, like, maybe he's the protagonist.
Like a loser?
They go from lower and he seems bigger and he seems ripped and they only, you know, like.
Oh. Smart.
Yeah.
I'm obsessed with the director.
It was fantastic.
Yeah.
It was really well
She's
done.
She's so
I think
cool.
I might go see it again.
Let's go.
Okay.
Should we go?
Yeah,
okay.
I'm down.
Okay. We'll circle
Should
back.
We do some weed?
Connor, I actually think
I don't do weed, by the way, you guys, at all. Ever.
I think actually that would be a situation, because remember that one time I smoked and there was a disturbing scene and then I actually, like, needed to go to the hospital?
Yeah.
I think that might happen.
Oh, well then don't.
But maybe it won't.
I don't know.
Yeah, it might. Anyway, what do you think about me knitting a Saltburn sweater?
I think that's
just with
great
the logo.
Idea. Yeah, that's a great idea.
Okay.
That would go, that would do numbies.
It's not even about the numbies.
Oh, it's always about the numbies for me.
I know. It's just about my sweater. Oh my God, I'm going to give it to Barry if we'll have it. Just send me your address. Here we go.
Cocktail City. Cocktail City with your sweatshirt.
Don't put me in a room with Barry or Jacob. Don't put me in a room. Don't put me
in a room.
I would hate to be in a room.
Time came out with their person of the year this year.
Right.
And last year, I was like, Brooke, who do you think person of the year is going to be? And the people nominated last year were like Malala and Dr. Fauci. And Brooke said, probably Catherine Hahn, like for no reason.
What do you mean no reason?
Well, I mean,
she does so much.
She's amazing. She's amazing, but like, where did you come up with Catherine Hahn?
I don't even think
she worked last year. I don't think she did.
She was in Glass Onion or something. And I just was reminded of how incredible she is.
She is amazing, but
she's in most of your favorite movies, Catherine Hahn is in, and you just don't give her the recognition that she deserves.
It was like,
and I would like time to step up to the plate.
President Zelensky versus Catherine Hahn, the two finalists.
Catherine Hahn.
Catherine Hahn, all the way.
Anyway, she wasn't it randomly.
Let's get her back in the zeitgeist for 2024.
But I'm not crazy because now it's Taylor Swift. So we are doing. What was that face for?
I mean, Taylor Swift operated at the level of like world leaders this year.
Okay, but I'm just saying, like, I'm not crazy in the sense of like not only guessing a politician or some like activist.
I'm just so happy because Barbie, just in general, was nominated. Barbie and the president of China.
Wait, Barbie was nominated for Person of the Year? Oh, Barbie the doll?
The doll.
Okay.
But I assume like the people that would accept the award would be the people that like put the movie together because it was like, it was historical in many senses of the word. But it really like doesn't matter. No offense to those involved. We're talking about like world leaders. Taylor Swift, I count as a world leader to me.
At this point, yeah.
Because of her effect on the economy. Yeah. She did more for the economy than any...
That's true.
Any U.S. official could or has.
That's true.
And yeah, like all of these world leaders like look at her and they'd be like, please come to our city, please. That was not supposed to be an accent. I don't know why I went into accent mode. That was an accident, but... An accent dent, but that was rightfully acquired.
I agree.
That being said... Catherine Hahn could have a huge 2024, so let's not write her
off. Fingers crossed. Catherine Hahn, come on the pod.
I would love that. Catherine Hahn.
I don't even know what I'd talk about.
Wait.
Actually, I could, every single movie I loved.
Did you see Julia Louis-Dreyfus got podcast of the year?
No, that's great.
I know. That is great. Well deserved.
Queen.
We have Izzy bringing us out some eggnog, because Brooke said she wanted to try eggnog. And I was like, Brooke should try eggnog, like... You know, that's like a Christmas tradition and whatever. And then I was like,
you should try pouring it too and see what that experience
is. Oh, like, is it going to be thick?
Try it first and then pour it. Because I don't want you to pour it. It's already in the
cup. Oh, it's in the cup. Okay. Can I read the, should I read the ingredients now or after?
I think read it after. Okay. I just want to say, like, when I was like, oh, Brooke should try eggnog, I realized at the end of the sentence, I was like, I've never tried eggnog.
It looks like custard.
Oh, it looks like it should be called eggnog.
Yeah.
Oh, I don't want to do it, really, to be honest. You're giving it a smell?
Smells fine.
What does it smell like?
Custard.
That doesn't make me feel better about it. Oh, this is nasty. Oh, this is so nasty.
I'm actually not feeling, like, as horrible as you. Okay. I will say, though, I am, like, kind of having a hard time getting it to
Brooke,
into my mouth.
Man.
You try it first.
Fuck you. Oh, that's good.
Really?
Yeah. Oh, that's real good.
Oh. I'm not going to keep drinking it, but it's fine.
Yeah, I can't imagine drinking a glass of this.
Totally not offensive at all. It, like, I could see myself liking it if it was, like, made into another kind of drink. And eggnog was an ingredient in a larger, like, more, like, chocolatey punch. Does that make sense? You okay or not really?
No, yeah, I'm just trying to figure out the flavor profile.
It's got
to
be.
I would love to not see it. I would love to not have to see the visual before it entered my mouth.
Oh, this is really like milk, cream, high fructose corn syrup.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Sugar, regular corn syrup.
Right.
Egg yolks, natural and artificial flavors, spice, more milk, gum. guar gum, carrageenan, of course, mono and diglycerides. Oh my God, no, you can't be having those diglycerides.
Oh no, you've my heart is stopping.
Turmeric.
Oh, it's healthy.
Color. No, that's the color. Turmeric, parentheses, color, and parentheses.
Turmeric,
salt, and disodium phosphate. That doesn't sound, I don't know what that is, but that can't be good. Love it. Totally
that
fine.
That is great. I was getting very much like Barry in the bathtub vibes when I first saw it.
Okay.
So then
that took me a second. Yeah.
So that was tough. That's a tough nut to swallow.
Literally.
Eggnog.
Yeah.
Tough nut to swallow. I wouldn't want to put alcohol on that because that seems like a recipe for disaster for me. In a bad way. Like I wouldn't even know. Because like that's like two acts of evil coming putting their heads together.
Yeah, my stomach feels like it would be sick.
I mean, I don't know. You love those peanut butter shots. That's like the same consistency.
Do you know how sick I was when I had 18 of those?
Just from sugar intake, I promise
you. I wasn't drunk at all.
I know.
I was sick. Like I had food poisoning.
No, you had about like 160 grams of sugar in like an hour.
I know.
You got like a childhood sugar rush.
It was like
with alcohol.
Yeah, really bad.
Do we touch on George Santos now?
I think I want to a little.
Okay. George Santos, where is he now? That's the question on everybody's lips. Well, I'll tell you where he is now, Brooke.
On Cameo.
George Santos is on Cameo and he's upped his rate from, I think he started at like $60 and now it's $200.
He's undercharging. I would literally pay $500, I think.
Well, it's available to you now for $300 off.
I'm saying if I care.
Oh, no. Now it's up to $400.
Oh, yeah. Is it problematic to say he's the king?
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. Very cool. Good to know. I'm just so entertained.
Yeah, he's...
And I joined late. Like, I knew that he was a problem. He was a problem child, but I wasn't really tuning in until far too late, until recently. I didn't know that he was the way he is.
It's funny because saying like his bio is the expelled member of Congress from New York City, former congressional icon with the painting nails emoji.
Yeah.
There's a lot of pride going into being expelled from Congress, and I'm pretty sure like you go to jail forever if you do what he did, right? So is he making some money and then heading off to
the
penitent?
I don't know.
I wish that they had a George Santos situation for dummies.
I just don't get how he was elected in the first place. I think that's where I'm confused.
I need to hit Spark.
But didn't he not even graduate high school?
I don't know. I don't know his background.
He lied a bunch.
Right.
He elected.
Oh, they put out.
But didn't they figure out that he lied like a while ago and he was still.
I think he was already elected.
Right. But wouldn't he be expelled once they figure out that he lied?
Well, that's where all the politics come in because like one portion didn't want to expel him until they actually had an indictment or like a, because then it's just, you're just expelling somebody based on rumors or like what they say.
But then they publicize his list of lies and it's like longer than an essay I wrote in college.
Yeah.
It's like, it's crazy. It's like, I lost my mom in 9/11 and she's like fully alive.
I want him to write a biography, an autobiography or memoir, whatever. And I want his version of the truth and I want on the next page the version of the truth side by side.
Oh, that would be fun.
You know, like as you're reading, like, okay, my mom died in 9/11, footnote, mom is still alive. Like I want that to be the whole.
Footnote, book. Mom's right behind him writing this.
Yeah, I mean, I am very entertained.
They could do community notes on anything he posted, probably.
Did you hear that he sounds just like Lola from Big Mouth?
Oh, yeah.
There's no difference.
Yeah, he does.
There's no difference between the voices. Can we play one?
Yeah. Oh, 100%.
There's no difference.
On your engagement. And also, I wanted to stop by and say thank you for your thankless public
thankless
service, Delaware legislature.
Mm-hmm.
It is not for the faint of heart. Staff is the most important part of a representative of government. You guys make it all work, and I'm so looking forward to see you guys.
How many people have this much money burning a hole in their pocket to give to George Santos? That's what's crazy to me.
I would be one of them.
No.
I fear.
He's really bad. Problematic.
I know that.
He's doing a limited number of videos. Okay, so he's only doing 28 more. Something
he has
tells
so
me,
many.
Something tells me. One thing about me and George, once you get a little taste of this, where he's like, people want me to make cameos, he'll up that number. $400 a video. What's 400 times 28?
A lot.
So he'll make 11 grand doing 28 more videos.
He's probably set for life now, which sucks because he's problematic, but unfortunately, like, I am entertained, and that's what sucks.
Oh, yeah, that is
that's
tough.
What sucks.
Hmm. And he's got a great rating on Cameo, actually. 4.96 is...
They're good. He's, like, good at it.
Yeah.
Like, he should have just gone right into entertainment.
He was a drag queen in Brazil.
I don't know. Was he pursuing that heavily, or was it just, like, a one-off?
He was pursuing it. I don't know. Heavily. I guess it depends who you ask. But maybe we'll do a deep dive in Close Friends on Georgie Poo.
No, because I'm... saying the wrong things.
What do you mean?
I literally called him a king.
That's okay. No, because a lot of people are. Like, the whole internet is.
It's just like I can't really look away is what I'm saying.
Yeah. Well, he's.
But I don't want to put my foot in my mouth anymore.
Oh, okay. Well, then we can.
What's done is done.
Okay.
I've said what I've said. I don't want to say anything else.
Facts.
Just in case, because I'm anxious.
Okay.
Always.
Well, then we can wrap up.
Yeah. Let's head into bonus.
Let's go into bonus, you guys. See ya. Thanks for listening.
Thank
we'll
you.
See you
Love
next
you.
Week.
This week on Close Friends.
Do you always wear a hat? You shouldn't, because you have fabulous lips and a rocking ass.
Your ass is so rocking. Please don't wear a hat.
Look at them touch that prairie dog's breasts. Oh my God, leave its breasts alone.
Forever. My landlord's so nice.
Oh my gosh, she has prisoner syndrome.
You are addicted to the human dolphin connection in a way that is something to think about for sure.
Sign up on tmgstudios.tv to watch the full bonus episode.